new function called live audio. So give it a name, whatever you want to call it. I'm going to call it guitar. And now, have guitar. So that's pretty cool. But what about effects? What about reverb or distortion? On this PiSound, I've got two inputs. So one input is the guitar, the other one is this Moog synthesizer. Oh, it's not working. So what do we need?
Code!
Where do we need it? No. This one's on input two. As you can see, it's very simple. Right, great. So we can have all the effects in the same way as well. That's cool. And what else do we want to do? So maybe we want to play both at the same time. Can we do both at the same time then?
Try.
So-called professional musician. So, what do we need to fix this problem?
A time machine.
Codes! No, a time machine, that'd be quite nice. And actually, one of the most exciting features in Sonic Pirates, I'm not going to talk about it, is a feature called Time Warp, which does allow you to go forwards and backwards in time. So you can actually time warp into the past, play it, and go back to the future again. But anyway, look it up, it's cool. So, what we want is to use code to do this. So, what do? Well, we have our live audio input, that's great. There's a really old standard from the 80s called MIDI, right? We just use the MIDI function. What note should we play? E3?
E3.
The computer will play the Moog synthesizer 4. And that's the same as play, it's the simplest play. So, these are, hopefully, is this similar for a 10-year-old child? I hope so. So, what can we do with this, right? Anything we want. Let's go E3, three octaves, particularly those, and let's put that in the library called Foo. What we're doing here is to have a very simple library, which is repeating round, playing octaves of E3, three of them, for a very short time with a small sync time. Notice the timing is unbelievably accurate. I have friends who work as professional audio engineers, and they say this is as accurate as able to fly in terms of time. Right, so there we are. And then what else do I want to do for a band? Yeah, so you've only got one pair of hands. So often people use looper pedals. Have you heard of looper pedals?
Yeah.
Where you record a track and you play another track and another track. So we might want to do that. So, what we can do is we can use an effect called record, and we give it a buffer name. This is like having a cassette player, so we write the name of it so we can remember it. And then we run the replay. So he's playing the guitar nicely. Oh, yeah. And stop the code, right? You can't play anymore. We don't need you anymore, Ben. Delete that. Play sample. What did I call it? B1. Buffer B1. We have ability to play pre-recorded sounds. Does that make sense? So now you can build your own looper pedals with code. And I think these three features together, used in combination, are going to really expand Sonic Pi's ability to pick become a central piece in any school band or professional band, because I think this is really, really important. And when I say professional, I mean it. Right? The timing in this is impeccable. The studio work in this is fabulous. And so it really is something that professionals are using and can use. And so if you're a child in a school using this, there is a pathway from you doing that to being a professional musician using the same tools. I think that's really the fundamental story behind Sonic Pi. Does that make sense? Right, any questions at this point? No? Have I described something to you that makes some kind of sense?
Yeah.
So do you think now you might be able to start using Sonic Pi as a band? Yeah? Oh, this didn't sound very exciting.
Yeah.
Or not? Well, maybe you're not sure, so we should demonstrate what we can do. Yeah, should we do it? So we've got 7 minutes. Maybe we can extend 5 minutes more. Can we have 5 more minutes, do you think?
Yeah.
Right, okay, let's do it. Right, are you ready? If you want to dance, you're very welcome to. Oh, so what do we need? We need some samples. Got any samples? So obviously in Sonic Pi you can use a Rebit sample, but you can download your own, you can make your own, record your own. So Ben's bought some samples. So is there any one here you want to use?
Bass
app.
Oh,
yeah, plug this in. Okay. So, what we tuned, samps, bass calls, boost. So, here's a whole folder for the samples, right? WAV files. Any WAV, AVE, or FLAC files will do. But instead of knowing all the names of samples, right, all you need to do is just get a folder. Let's just delete this and put /explorer. And drag the folder across. And there's your. The path to the folder. Now, I just write the word sample, and it will play me the first sample in that folder. I'll play the chords. That's the one you want. What I can do is I can define foo to be this thing, and now I can just do sample to foo. But I can also just play number three. We start counting, you can decide from zero, right? So two is three. It's a bit annoying, but. This is what you want. Okay, so this is the start of our piece. So should we go to 9 o'clock?
I think so.
Can we do some of the lights? I've also predefined a whole bunch of these sample names down here. These here, they just function from return the path, so I don't have to